guys, it's kimdao here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you are all well and safe. We are currently in lockdown in Sydney and it's not looking good. I think we'll be in lockdown for a couple more months. So yeah, looks like I'll be stuck at home for a while. But anyway, last year I made a video where I opened up 100 gachapons in Akihabara, Tokyo. A lot of people really enjoyed that video and wanted me to make more just like it. And unfortunately, because I'm, you know, stuck in Australia, I cannot travel and people cannot travel to Japan right now. If you want to get anything from Japan, it is very difficult. So in today's video, I managed to snag 50 gachapon and I'm going to show you guys how I did it. Earlier this year, I did my yearly videos where I opened up book rolls, and I do this every single year. Like usually for New Year's, I'm always in Japan and I'm able to go to the shops myself to buy them. But unfortunately, because of what's going on, I couldn't. So I managed to find a shipping service and I used From Japan back in January. So I managed to get the book rolls delivered from Japan to me in Australia. So that was how I was able to make those videos. So fast forward a couple months later, From Japan contacted me and we are doing a collaboration together. So this video is sponsored by From Japan. From Japan is a shipping service, so you are able to shop in Japan. They will buy the items for you, ship it to their warehouse, and then they will ship the items to you. Almost all of the items will be covered by the product protection plan to make sure that the parcel is fully insured and will arrive to you safely, and also for non-deliveries. Now, if there is a specific item that you want to buy in Japan but can't find online, you can actually use From Japan's Find It For Me service and a staff member will hunt it down for you. So how From Japan works, you find the item you want to buy, you can search on their website or copy and paste the URL of the item page into From Japan's search bar, and then you can complete the price quote and pay for the first charge. Once the item has arrived in the warehouse, you will get a notification and then you'll have to pay the second charge, which is the shipping fee and a product protection plan for your items to travel from Japan to yourself. And that's it. It was such an easy process. Once again, I used them myself and it wasn't sponsored back in January, and I was able to get my items super quickly. So I got my gachapon here. And I also got some Remint sets. I got these from a Remint website that unfortunately does not ship overseas. Hence, From Japan was able to get these for me. So let's open them all up. All right, let's start. We have 50 gachapon to get through. The first set is a vending machine one, which I thought was really cool. So let's open them up. The first one here, we have a red vending machine. I love the attention to detail in this. Like, look at these little drinks. These are like the drinks that you will find in vending machines in Japan. It's so cool. Now, it also came with a little Coca-Cola drink, and you can put this in the back of the vending machine. So just gonna pop that in and close it up, and then turn around, you can press this button and the drink will come out of the vending machine. How cool is that? You can open it up and it comes out. Oh, I love it so much. It's amazing. Next gachapon is this white vending machine. Now, if we look closely to the drinks, it is actually different to the red vending machine. So I think that's really cool. It does not come with a small drink. I'm not sure if I lost it or it just doesn't come with one, but oh well. Next one we have is a blue vending machine. So once again, it is different to the other vending machines. This one is a Blue Mountain coffee machine. Also didn't come with a small drink. I thought that all of them should come with one, but oh well. Unfortunately, only the red one so far has come with a small drink. The next one is a black vending machine, and this one actually came with a small drink. So yeah, I'm kind of confused as to why the others didn't, but this one here, if you open it up, there is the little drink that you can put inside, and then you can press the button, it comes out. And the last one is actually a box of green tea. So when I opened it, you will find all these little mini green tea drinks. So there are actually 20 of them in there. So these are the same size as a small mini drink, so you can actually put these inside the vending machines. So I decided to put like 4 or 5 into each one. So that definitely makes up for the machines that did not come with the small drinks. And that is the first set. I think this is so cool. So the next set is a Pokemon one, and this was wrapped like this. Unfortunately, it did not come with the actual Gachapon balls, but because this is a Gachapon video, I'm just going to put them back into the balls and we're going to pretend they came from one, because that's the point of this video, right? We'll just fake it till we make it, it's alright. So the first one in the Pokemon set is a Pikachu holding some berries with its ears back. That's so cute. Whenever my Shiba Inu is like really happy, her ears go back like that as well. And the second one in this Pokemon series is this Dratini. So Dratini with some berries, very, very cute. The next one is a Yampa with berries. And then we got a Chespin with berries. So obviously when you're doing this in Japan, you don't get to pick which one you get because it's by chance. And it's the same when you buy them online as well, but you can actually buy the whole sets, which is what I did. So I get every single one of them. And the final one, which is my favorite, is this Gengar with berries. I think he looks so cool. I love it. And that is the second set, Pokemon with berries. The third set is a Shiba Inu one, and you guys know I just got a Shiba Inu recently, so I'm very, very excited to open this one up. So the first one, we have a Shiba Inu playing with some sandals. Luckily, my dog does not actually touch my shoes. It's pretty cool. Like, I just leave my shoes lying around the house and she just ignores them. Next one, we have a Shiba Inu, and I'm not sure exactly what this is. Looks like a lantern. So it looks like a little dog toy, I don't know, but it's pretty cute. And this is a cream Shiba Inu. And then number 13, we have the same thing. It's a Shiba Inu with that same lantern toy, but it's a red Shiba Inu. And the next one, we have a cream Shiba Inu with a hat. How adorable is that? So cool. And then number 15, we have a white Shiba Inu with a hat. It's just like sleeping, just chilling there. Next we got a black and tan Shiba Inu. I wish that there were more of these in this color because that's Pinna's color. But he comes with some sandals. And that is a Shiba Inu collection. There are 6 of them in total. Okay, so when it comes to Gachapon, I really like food ones. So I got a set of bread Gachapon. So number 17, we have bread inside this packaging and it's squishy, guys, so satisfying. When I was editing my previous Gachapon video, I really regretted not doing more food ones. So we're going to do quite a lot in this video. The next one we have is just a slice of bread and it's squishy. I love these so much. I am definitely using all of these keychains. The next one we have is a Castella, also in some plastic packaging, and yep, it is squishy. So, freaking love these so much. They look so realistic. Like, that's what I love about them. And number 20, we have a bread, and I think it's like a cream one, so there must be some cream inside. And number 21, this is the last one. This is a loaf of bread and you have to put it together yourself. So you've got the bread, which is so squishy, yes. And then you put it inside this packaging yourself. So we're just going to slide him in and you just wrap it up yourself. So, look at that. You can add a chain to it too. Probably my favorite one. And that is a set of breads. Set number 5, we have mochi bunnies. So these come in individual pieces, you just have to put them together. So the first one is a bunny sitting on a bench, and then you've got a box, and inside the box is some mochi. The next one is a bunny with a bunny mochi. That's very fitting. He's super cute too. The next one we have is a bunny with a hammer and a mochi. So from my understanding, I could be wrong, I've seen videos on this, but when you make mochi in Japan, you have one person hitting the mochi and one person just rotating it. And I think it's because you want to let more air into the mochi, so you've got that consistency. So yeah, it's so adorable. Number 25, we are halfway there already, guys. So we have a bunny, it looks like he's drinking, and you've got some mochi in a bowl. Number 26, we have a bunny with some mochi, and he's got a fan as well. Look at that, so adorable. Like, I just love how in Japan, the gachapons just have so much attention to detail. If I was doing this in Japan and getting a random one, I'd be happy with any of them, to be honest. And the final one from this series, it's a bunny toasting some dango. and that is a bunny mochi set. Even though I said I'll be happy with any one of them, and I will be, I think my favorite would be the bunny with the hammer. Set number 6 is cafe bunnies. So I love food gachapons, but I do like cute animals as well, so why not put cute animals and food together? This one looks like a bunny bagel. Oh, look at him, he's so adorable. Next one in the bunny set is a bunny in a coffee cup. So, oh, look at that, it's so cute. And the next one, we have a bunny holding up a welcome sign for a cafe. And next, we have a different bunny holding up a different sign saying good taste on it. Next one, it's similar to the very first one we opened up, and it is a bunny with a white bagel. Next is another bunny in a coffee cup, kind of looks like a Starbucks one. Oh, look at that. He's so adorable just sitting in there like that. Oh my gosh, I love him. This is a set of bunnies. This next set is probably one of my favorites, the convenience store set. So this first one is some waffles. So if you guys have been to Japan and been to convenience stores, you may recognize some of the items in this set, which is super cool. Next, we have a slice of fruit roll cake, and oh, it's so cute. Unfortunately, it's not squishy, but it just looks so realistic. Just opening all this really makes me miss Japan and just eating convenience store food all the time. Yep, I am definitely putting this on my key rings. The next one we have is a, looks like a custard parfait, and oh my gosh, guys, this brings back so many memories because I used to eat this stuff all the time. So, look how realistic it is. Look at this, the pudding there. You've got fruits. So adorable. Love it. And then the last one we have is this cupcake. It's packaged like exactly how convenience stores would pack it in Japan. To be honest, I would prefer it without this plastic packaging on it. But either way, it is still really cute and at least it's realistic. The next one we have is a banana roll. So I don't think I ever had this in Japan because I don't really like bananas very much, but it is still super cute. And that is the convenience store set. Next we have these ramen sets. Now guys, I used to buy these Sailor Moon ones all the time, and I filmed a video on it. I just never uploaded it for some reason, but in Japan, you can buy these individual boxes and you don't know what is inside. But if you want the whole set, you can buy the whole box and you're guaranteed every single one of them. So I had the whole box of the corgi ones. So let's open them all up individually to see what we get. This is what the individual box looks like. You have 5 different corgis and 1 surprise one. Let's open up the first box. So it's inside this black plastic bag, so you can't take a sneak peek on what is inside. And I think the first one is actually the secret one, mystery one. And I'm just looking and yes, it is. So yeah, that's pretty cool. The very first one we got was the secret one. And look at him, it's just a corgi on a harness. How cute, he's so thick, look at him. Alright, number 40. Let's open up the second corgi one. And once again, inside a black plastic bag, we're just going to rip it open. There's a hole there, so it makes it easier to rip open. This one here, oh, look at him. This one is the corgi butt. Oh, look at this thick boy. Number 41. Alright, let's just rip this bag open to see what we get. And oh, it's a corgi hot dog. That is so adorable. I love it. Oh my gosh, he's so cute. Look at his wink. Number 42. Guys, we're almost there. We only have a few left. So this one here, let's see. It is a corgi sleeping with a rubber duck. Oh, I love it. Kind of reminds me of Hina in a way. Even though the markings are like completely different, kind of looks like her, right? The next box, let's just rip it open and take out the black bag. And this one here is a corgi with a scarf. Oh, look at him, he looks so happy. And one ear's up, one ear's down. I think this is the last one. And oh my god, it is a corgi with a donut in his mouth. I think this is my favorite one out of all of them. That is freaking adorable. So that is the corgi set. I think, yep, my favorite is the corgi with the donut in his mouth.
Set number 9, guys, I decided to save the best till last. This is a Pokemon stained glass one. I think it's so pretty and it's awesome for decoration, so I'm definitely going to use this to put around my apartment. We have 5 of them in total, so let's open up this first one. So I didn't know this, but you actually have to set it up yourself. Luckily it's super simple, there's only like 2 steps to each one. So let's just cut up the bag and we're just going to put it together. So first up we have a Lugia one. I think I recall seeing stuff like this when I was in Japan last time, which was like 2 years ago now. Feels so weird because I used to travel to Japan like multiple times a year and I haven't been back because of the pandemic. But yeah, these sets are just so awesome. I love them. So this one, you just stick the Lugia to the back stained glass and then you've just got these electric thingamabobs coming out. Oh, it's so pretty. Look at it. All right, the next one, number 46. We have the stained glass and we're just gonna put this patch of grass on, and it's an Umbreon one, so he just sits on top. And then we also have like this cloud coming out because he's a dark type. And there we go. Oh, so nice. It's so simple, but so nice. All right, number 47. This one here, we're just going to cut it up and it looks like a Mew one, and oh, it's so pretty. I love these pastel colors. So the stained glass goes in the back and then Mew is on a bubble, so you just kind of have to play around until it sticks and then you're gonna put these bubbles into, and look at that. Oh, so nice. Number 48 is a Pikachu one, so we're just going to cut that open and then Pikachu's on this grass. I'm gonna stick the grass onto the stained glass and got this electric thing coming out. Oh, so nice, love it too. This second last one, guys, number 49, is a Gardevoir. And oh, look at these pastel colors. I feel like my favorite ones will be the pastel ones. So this one just sticks on very easily and it's so pretty. Wow, amazing. And finally, the last one we have is a Ho-Oh. So we're just gonna take out the stained glass, and if you guys played the game, this is a tower, I believe, that he was in when you want to go and capture him. And we're just gonna put these fire flames things on and there we go, done. And that is the whole Pokemon set. I definitely can see myself using this to decorate my apartment because, like, I mean, my whole apartment's Pokemon anyways, right? But they just look so nice and aesthetic. And actually, I feel like I can put these in my filming background. My favorite would have to be the Mew or the Gardevoir for sure. But yeah, I absolutely love this so much.
That is the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this just as much as I enjoyed opening them. So once again, if you want to find anything in Japan, check out my link down below, and From Japan can help you out. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. And if you guys have any more requests for videos that you want me to make, let me know in a comment box down below as well. I also have a vlogging channel if you want to see what I get up to in my everyday lockdown life. And I also have a gaming channel if you want some Genshin Impact guides. And also Hina has her own channel if you want to see her growing up. Follow me on all my social media, which I will link down below, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye guys.